Hi, this is Michael Buckhoff, and today it is definitely time to get back to the basics. I'm going up to run in the mountains, the San Gabriel Mountains, a little bit beyond Wrightwood. This is the famous Pacific Crest Trail. It goes from Mexico all the way to Canada. Today I'm just going out for about 10 or 11 miles. I'm gonna catch up with some ultra runners here in about 4 or 5 miles. But I gotta tell you, starting this run, I just started, but the elevation's so high and it's so hilly. It takes a mile or so to get used to the altitude, to say the least. I just took a quick break to take a shot at some of these mountains. That's Baden Powell there. I'm just kind of going in a circle. Here's some other hills. Mountains, I should say. I think this is Mount Baldy in the background. I've run to all the tops of these mountains. Tell you, it's quite a inspiration running up here, to say the least. You come up on these huge trees. I mean, take a look at this. Look at that thing. I mean, just how one side, but these things are massive. Look at that. And the people who maintain the trail, they come out here with these huge chainsaws, and as the trees fall down in the winter, they cut them down in the springtime. That part around the desert kind of meets the mountains. You can see over here, you got Mount Baden Powell. Then over here, in that distance, we see kind of the hazy area. That's actually the high desert. Here we are, we're at Inspiration Point, and we have two great runners here now, John Marnell and sir, what's your name? Now you guys, here's a quick question. Now we're all over 40.
Yeah.
I'm 43. John, you're how old?
64.
And sir?
53.
Now how do you guys keep your legs young?
Running. Running mountains.
Miles and miles and miles.
Here comes some of our runners.
Okay. And this year it was 131 miles because running through Death Valley in July in 130 degree temperatures isn't enough.
Wow.
There was a forest fire at the finish, which forced them to move the finish line up. So.
Now, what's your secret to your keeping your legs young and doing all these incredibly very well-run races? How do you keep yourself uninjured?
A brain damage. Good answer. The truth is that I'd like to say that I'm incredibly well-balanced, but obviously because what I do what I do, that's not necessarily the case. I'm kind of at a point where I do occasionally get injured, or I'm right on the brink of an injury.
What kind of injury problems do you face?
Most recently at Badwater, I had an issue with the tendons on the top of my foot.
Okay.
Due to the fact that I had some blistering and I had to run on my foot kind of on the side.
Oh, okay.
So, but it was severe enough that I actually thought it was a stress fracture.
Wow.
But I was back running after 10 days. So, but I think as I've been doing this a few years, I'm kind of to the point where I've learned when something is coming on, and then I back off. I take care of it, I rest, I recover, I do what I have to.
Nice view of the trail ahead of us, Mike.
Yeah, it is. This is a back to basics mountain run right here. It's a good run to reset. Tired of running through stop signs, traffic signals, having cars pass you. This is the kind of run you want right here. It's kind of like when Rocky, one of the Rocky movies, he went back to pulling weights and tires and logs in the snow and stuff and got away from all the high-tech stuff. This is it right here. I've been running about 1 hour 32 minutes, and today I didn't wear my GPS watch. I don't care what pace I'm running. This is just enjoyable, easy pace. Very nice run. This is just about it. It's 11 miles, and this is my back to the basics ride, back to the mountains. Have you done one of these runs lately?